We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Year Zero, Issue 1. This is a five-part miniseries from Artists, Writers, and Artisans, or AWA. This is written by Benjamin Percy, with art by Ramon Rosanas, colors by Lee Loughridge. Sal Cipriano was letterer, Kaare Andrews cover. The cover is boring. I don't know what that's supposed to be. It's just generic wilderness photography with a Photoshop RV. That is not inspiring me to buy anything. So this is really just an introduction issue. We get to see several different characters and what their occupations are. They're a very diverse crowd. One's a kid from Mexico City whose mother was killed and he's a street urchin. We've got an assassin. We've got a survival nut. We've got some lady in the Arctic. We've got another woman that's in Kabul who's like trying to rescue some women, and things go pretty horribly wrong. It's just sort of an introduction to the zombie apocalypse. The real selling point for this is the twist ending, which actually was a twist ending. Although this is very much generic zombie fiction, the ending really does throw an interesting twist into it. Was it good? It was okay. It wasn't the greatest thing ever. The zombie thing is very much overdone at this point, and it's a little trite because there's only so many ways the zombie apocalypse can be told, and so far nothing particularly new is added. But the art is pretty solid. I was actually pretty impressed with that. I'm not sure who Ramon Rosanas is, but he's a pretty good artist. Some of the background stuff didn't really work for me, but overall pretty solid work. Some really cool scenes, and the writing was fine. It's just kind of a generic zombie story. It's like every first episode of every zombie TV show ever, so there's not a lot here to work with. You do get kind of the standard archetype survival characters that you would get in any role-playing game or TV show that are of course going to follow through their path and probably eventually meet up. Was it the worst thing I've ever read? No. Was it worth $4? Probably not. If you're real into zombies, you'll like it, but it just wasn't for me. I think the zombie thing's been played out pretty heavily in the last decade, and this really didn't stand out very well. It felt very much like it's just being written for a Netflix deal, like a lot of the AWA books seem to be, but it was okay. I didn't hate it, but if you're a big zombie fan, you're gonna like it, most likely. I'll check out issue 2 if I could find it, but so far this first issue really didn't have a lot to work with. I would only recommend this if you're real big into zombie stories or horror stories. Beyond that, there's nothing new here. It's ground that's been tread dozens of times. So not for me, but I'll check out issue 2 to see if it's got some interesting twists. It's only a 5-part story, so maybe we'll continue to look at it, but so far it's not blowing me away. The art's solid, the story seems okay, it's just kind of been done 1,000 times by now. That's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel otherwise, links are in the description and on the about page, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.